As Philip convalesced, Alice more and more took Ruth's place as his entertainer, and read to him by the hour when he did not want to talk, about Ruth, as he did a good deal of the time. Nor was this altogether unsatisfactory to Philip. He was always happy and contented with Alice. She was the most restful person he knew, better informed than Ruth, and with a much more varied culture, and bright and sympathetic. He was never weary of her company, if he was not greatly excited by it. She had upon his mind that peaceful influence that Mrs. Bolton had when, occasionally, she sat by his bedside with her work. Some people have this influence, which is like an emanation. They bring peace to a house. They diffuse serene content in a room full of mixed company, though they may say very little, and are apparently unconscious of their own power. Not that Philip did not long for Ruth's presence all the time. Since he was well enough to be about the house, she was busy again with her studies. Now and then her teasing humor came again. She always had a playful shield against his sentiment. Philip used sometimes to declare that she had no sentiment, and then he doubted if he should be pleased with her after all, if she were at all sentimental, and he rejoiced that she had, in such matters, what he called the airy grace of sanity. She was the most gay, serious person he ever saw. Perhaps he was not so much at rest or so contented with her as with Alice, but then he loved her, and what have rest and contentment to do with love? End of chapter 41. The Gilded Age, A Tale of Today by Mark Twain and C.D. Warner. Chapter 42. Mr. Buckstone's campaign was brief, much briefer than he supposed it would be. He began it proposing to win Laura without being won himself, but his experience was that of all who had fought on that field before him. He diligently continued his effort to win her, but he presently found that, while as yet he could not feel entirely certain of having won her, it was very manifest that she had won him. He had made an able fight, brief as it was, and that at least was to his credit. He was in good company now. He walked in a leash of conspicuous captives.